Hi guys, my name is Henrik Reis, I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. Do you've ever felt overwhelmed by all the components that Jetpack Compose provides you? All the endless searching at the material website for the documentation of components and so on? What if I told you that there's a new IDE plugin for Android Studio, which is essentially a built-in encyclopedia in Android Studio, which will support you in the process of developing Android apps with Jetpack Compose? The founders of the Compose Hammer IDE plugin reached out to me and asked me if I could make a video about this plugin. So I looked into it and I think it could be really beneficial for many developers of you. So in this video, we will take a look at it. And as a bonus, I have 30 discount codes for you for this plugin. So I'm not paid by them, so I can give an honest review, but enough of the talk, let's dive right into it. So here in Android Studio, you can see I'm at the plugins window and Compose Hammer by IV Apps is already installed. This plugin is a paid plugin, so there is a 30-day trial and I'm currently on it, so I have 26 days left. And here you can already see there's a lot of content this plugin provides. And let's see what the features actually are. We can open up here a sidebar and we can see that here a list of various Material 3 components. We have here buttons, we have card switches, radio buttons, dialogues, chips, and so on. So regardless of what you want to do, there's no need to go into the Material 3 guidelines. You can directly from your IDE see what components are available. And of course, if you, for example, click on batch here and then on view, first all the required imports open up here and you can directly copy them, paste it in your IDE, and then next, of course, the batch box here itself. Once again, copy, and I can paste it in here. And as you can see, now I have all the things here. Now I need to opt in because it's still experimental, but that's a really nice feature. So no need for going into the guidelines and so on. But if you then want to go into the guidelines, you can also directly do it here from this window. So you have a link to the docs, guidelines, and specifications. So that's really nice. No need to wait for your project to build to see a little preview of these components. And if you don't memorize the component, you can directly look it up here. So while this built-in panel here is already really helpful, because I no longer need to go into the documentations, at least if I only want to look up the components. I mean, you have always the option to go into the direct documentation of these components here and see what they offer for you. But a really nice feature is the quick action. So when I hit, I'm at the Windows computer right now, so if I hit Alt and Enter, I get here the quick option Compose Hammer, and now I can click on it. And as you can see, we have various options here. So not only all the components we just saw, but also quick actions like Quick UI, Compose Runtime, and animations. So it's not only about these UI components. We can also, let's see, use this Compose Runtime here. So we have like Remember, Local Context Current, Coroutine Scope, and some other helpful Compose Runtime options. So let me quickly try out Open Link in the browser. And as you can see, we get the local URI handler here and can directly open up the URI here with an example link. The one bug I just saw, the import here got added right before the package name, but I think that is not a huge problem. So, but let's go back to the quick actions here and see what's left here. Quick UI. So we have also modifiers, column, spacer, images, and so on. And you can see when I insert them that all the boilerplate code directly gets inserted and I only have to replace all these values. And also at the last point, let's look at the animation, what that offers for us. We have here crossfade, animating the P and the color. And as an example here, if you want to animate the color here, it's from blue to red. And also a label got added, so we can quickly adapt these code snippets to our needs. Now that we saw the plugin in a theoretical way, we looked at all the features. Next, let's take a look at the little example. I will try to build a simple login screen only with Compose Hammer. So we focus on the UI part here. And let's say we first want a header image, then input fields. So we skip the sign up part. We only do the login. And we have two input fields, a login button, and yeah, that's it essentially. So let's see. First, I need a layout. So let's see, where can I find it? Layout, compose. Okay, that's already missing. So it's really only the, here, top app bars, but I think, okay, nice. It already provides also the scaffold around it. And now we have here a lazy column. That's not what we need. We will use a simple column. And then we say here modifier padding, and add the inner padding here. So next we want to have an image here. We go to quick UI, and once again we say here image, and I already prepared a little example image. So header image, and yeah, then next we say we want to have a title maybe, and we once again get to quick text and login into the app. And maybe we can also say here login screen. Next we need our first input field, so text fields probably outlined, and yeah, we have directly here our input field. Let's say instead of label, username, and then once again compose hammer, text fields outlined, and now we take our password. We should adapt this to text 2. And at the last step, maybe we could use a horizontal spacer. That's quite nice because that really annoys me with writing over and over again these spacers. And as a last step, let's take a button and we say elevated button, and it's login in this case. So let's see how that looks like. Maybe we also add another padding here and say 16 dp, and yeah, let's see how that looks like. And as we can see, we directly have a rudimentary screen, no styling at all, but we have a login button, we have our input fields here, and now I could start and put in my states here and wiring up all the components. And yeah, so for first start or prototyping, that was really nice to have. So now after the first impressions, what do you think? Would you use such an IDE plugin? let me know in the comments. So in my opinion, it could be really beneficial for many developers out there that just get started with Jetpack Compose to get an overview about all these components. So you no longer have to go through the web and search all this stuff. You have them all bundled directly into your IDE. However, I have some minor concerns with this plugin. For example, are the maintainers going to stay up to date with the recent changes? What's going on if they are breaking changes? Your project is on an older version of Material 3 and the breaking change comes with the new version and the plugin version is targeted on a new version. What do you do? So maybe it would be beneficial to somehow set your Material 3 version so the plugin can take it up and show you the components aligned with this Material 3 version. Also, I have the feeling there are some components that are not really necessary. For example, the local context, which are essentially three words. You can quickly memorize, I think. If you know about context, just say local context, current, and you have your context. So maybe you can shrink these components a little bit. So it's also easier to find what you really need. But overall, it's a great collection of functions and components for Jetpack Compose. And to compare it with another plugin I looked at, with the Compose Helper plugin in one of my recent videos, this is of course more powerful, but has another use case than the Compose Helper plugin. But check out the video if you missed it. So if you want to try out the Compose Helper plugin, go to the plugins page in your Android Studio, install it and activate the trial. The 30-day trial is for free. And if you decide to go on a subscription, then you can use one of the coupon codes I will put in the YouTube comment section. The codes are valid until 7th July 2023. If you see this video somewhere in the future. And have fun. Let me know what you think about the plugin. And as always, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.